Hello, collectors. Welcome to episode 13 of Statue Talk. I'm your host, Joe Prodzik. With me today is a guy who refuses to take off this Spider-Man mask, Quang Tran. So excited about the Captain America Civil War that we saw last Saturday that I can't get him to take this thing off. So, thanks for joining us on this week's episode. Statue Talk is a show where Quang and I share with you upcoming statue previews, pre-orders, updates to our collection, a couple videos from other collectors that I think you might enjoy. So thanks for joining us on this week's episode. Now, Spidey, hit the music.
Ten.
So, now that Quang has decided to take off his Spider-Man mask, we can get started with this week's episode. Got some cool things to show you.
Yeah.
Some really big reveals from Sideshow. A couple of things from XM Studios. And this cool custom picture just came out for today.
Ooh,
that you might really like. So, Quang, what's new with you? You're just obviously excited.
Yeah, of
having
course.
Seen Captain America Civil yep. War.
Good movie. Finished Aliens yesterday. I'll give that set back to you. Surprisingly, like I said, it was earlier. Fourth one wasn't as bad as I thought it was. It's the worst out of all of them. Well, I'll probably say third one wasn't that good as well. Finished Arkham... Did I say that last week? Did I finish Arkham Asylum?
Finished Arkham Asylum this week.
Yeah, finished Arkham Asylum this week. Other than that, nothing. Oh, yeah, then I have a picture of the collection update, which I'll do during the collection update.
So. Right, you went to IKEA.
Yep.
And he went to IKEA and got yourself a detail.
Yep.
And you bought the wrong color.
Yes, I did.
You bought a white one, and you wanted a
black one. I was so disappointed.
So Quang was sort of asking me how he can adjust the shelves on his detail to fit the quarter-scale premium format, so I sent you an email.
Yeah, I haven't really... It looked a little weird.
So you're going to... you know, the detail from IKEA comes with four set shelf heights. Mm-hmm. But lots of people, either they take out two of the shelves and just do half and half.
Yeah.
But you can also, if you have smaller premium formats, you can also fit three of them inside a detail if you want to. You get these things called wire clips.
Mm-hmm.
And you clip it on the bar of the corner of the shelf. And so that you can adjust it to any height that you want. So that's what those are for that I sent you. I'm going to pick some up for myself to kind of change the heights of my shelves on my two details.
I'll have you, once you get that, I'll check yours out for it. Because it was a little confusing. When I was looking at it, it was really confusing to me.
Yeah, there's a lot of good information on there on how to hack your IKEA stuff.
Yeah.
Now, while he was at IKEA, he saved me a trip to IKEA myself. Don't do that. Don't do that. He saved me a trip to IKEA myself by giving me the lights back there for my PAX display units, which I spent Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday, I spent rearranging my room. I had to pull out the PAX shelves and adjust the lights. I'll share some more of that with you in the collection update. But this week mostly was playing with my shelves. I am still trying to beat Uncharted 3.
Yeah, I saw you playing that yesterday.
I'm at 75% now, so I kind of have to hold off on playing Uncharted 4 still, and I haven't even unboxed the collector's edition that Quang picked up for me. So I've been doing that, and then last Saturday, we finally saw Civil War.
Yes.
So Quang, what did you think of Captain America Civil War?
I think it's a great movie. Huge thing is that I watched it three times. Each time I watched
it. You watched it three times?
Yeah.
I thought you watched it twice.
No, three times. So each time I watched it, I felt like I found a little bit more of a flaw in the movie.
Mm-hmm.
So in the end, I would rate it 7.5.
Okay.
For people, you know, if you haven't watched the movie yet, I would say skip this part. Because, dude, Spider-Man kicked three people's ass. You don't see anybody else doing that in the movie.
Well, we have a little bit of a different opinion about Spider-Man in the movie. As cool as Spider-Man was, I thought he was forced into the movie. I thought him and Ant-Man were both forced into the movie and didn't really belong. I did like the movie. I enjoyed it a lot. I don't like it. Like my favorite Marvel movie would be Winter Soldier.
Yep, I agree.
I didn't like it better than Winter Soldier, right? But I still thought it was a good movie. I thought Captain America got enough time. Because it was a... Like, for example, it was a season two of Daredevil, right? Mm-hmm. So Daredevil and Punisher and Elektra.
Yeah.
Well, I thought in that season, they didn't really focus on Daredevil.
True.
They focused on Punisher and Elektra. So I was worried about that same thing happening in Civil War,
mm-hmm.
With them sort of putting Captain America off to the side. But they didn't do that too much. He didn't get lost in the movie. You know, still lots of moments with Captain America going to, spoiler alert, Agent Carter's funeral.
Yeah.
You know, yeah, spoiler alert, an old-ass lady is dead in the movie. Yeah, so they still had those nice moments with kissing that girl and, you know, still had the good Captain America moments. Reason why I liked Winter Soldier so much was those Captain America moments, and I'm glad it was still kind of a Captain America movie, although Iron Man was pretty heavy in the movie, too.
Yeah, I felt like it was Captain America 50%, 25% Robert Downey Jr., 15% Winter Soldier, and then the rest five is like Scarlet Witch, Hawkeye, blah, blah, blah. I really like Spider-Man a lot, even though I'm biased with it, but I felt that I really liked Ant-Man as well, a lot, actually.
And he was funny, yeah.
I just felt like he didn't have enough screen time, because it was just, what, one and a half scene that he was in?
Well, it felt almost too much like an Avengers movie rather than a Captain America movie. I didn't think the Avengers quite overwhelmed the movie.
Yeah.
It was a delicate balance, but I think they got it right for the movie that this is, Civil War. I think they got it right. Mm-hmm. So now, Kwong, the big question is Captain America Civil War better than Batman versus Superman?
Yes.
You know what, Kwong? It doesn't matter.
Everybody
Who cares?
Has their own opinion,
Who cares?
Everybody
Nobody cares.
Opinion,
We got two superhero movies, Batman vs. Superman. We've got Captain America Civil War within weeks of each other. Instead of arguing about it, we just go to the movies and sit down and watch and either enjoy it or don't. You know, you don't need to get crazy about it. You don't need to, you know, poop on Batman vs. Superman or Captain America Civil War. Yeah. Either way, so... You know, we have those two movies. We can both enjoy them. I like one movie better than the other, and that's with all things. That's okay.
And then we're going to be throwing in X-Men in like three weeks into that mix, too.
I will go watch that movie, but fuck that movie.
Yeah.
I'm not...
Imagine
I'm going to give it a shot.
Yeah, me too.
Because I got to see it first, but from the trailers... I'm super disappointed, especially in Apocalypse, because I really like the Apocalypse character. And, you know, like I said previously, I'd rather I'd rather have an X-Men collection than an Avengers collection, because I've always liked the X-Men better, but they haven't done... Movies have been okay, but they haven't done them justice.
Like I said, I still think Days of the Future Past is probably the best X-Men movie next to First Class.
Yeah, those two movies are good, and they were on the right track.
Mm-hmm.
Seems like they're going off the rails a little bit.
Yeah.
But anyway, that's enough movie talk. Let's get down to statue talk. So let's take a look at some previews and pre-orders. So Kwong, first up, another custom.
Oh.
So this custom statue... was just shared today on multiple groups on Facebook, so I wanted to share them here with you today on Statue Talk. This is a custom that was posted by Trung Mao, and it's a sneak peek of a masterpiece that will consist of two full statues, Flash versus Reverse Flash. Now this is sculpted by AVI Sculpture. Hope I'm saying that right. AVI Sculpture. So this is Flash versus Reverse Flash. We haven't gotten really good Flash statue yet.
Yeah, I went to, when I was going to watch Civil War with my friend, we went to a comic book store and I was just like, oh dude, it would be awesome to get like a Flash statue. Mm-hmm. Cause I saw some DC Collectibles one, but nothing that really, I was like, dang, I gotta get that. It just wasn't really as good, but this one looks amazing.
Yeah, it looks really cool. You know, Prime 1 is coming out with the Flash 2, new 52 version. Mm-hmm. This Flash versus Reverse Flash Cat Custom looks really good. It will be, you know, customs are really limited.
Yeah.
A little bit more expensive, so, but this one looks really cool.
I'm curious, did they say what scale it's going to be?
Not specifically, they're usually quarters.
Yeah, oh, that's really cool.
So yeah, really cool statue of Flash versus Reverse Flash. Next up is a video game statue. Yep. Y'all know I like video games. Not a huge fan of this one.
Yeah. You don't like Nintendo?
Yeah, I'm not a big Nintendo guy, so this is a Nintendo statue. This is Metroid Samus. I don't even know how to say this. Say the name Samus correctly. So this is the Samus suit from Metroid. Now this is, I know there are a lot of Metroid and Nintendo fans out there, so this does look like a really cool statue though. We've shared a couple of first for figure statues in the last couple weeks, right? So they're doing some interesting and unique things. Are you a Metroid fan?
Not really.
Because you play more Nintendo.
Yeah, I play a lot of more Nintendo. I was waiting for the HD kind of remix to be done on the Wii U because Metroid was like on the Wii or something like that. I haven't played it. It looks really good, but then again, I'm not really a first-person shooter kind of guy. But I heard the storyline is really amazing.
Well, Metroid traditionally is a side-scroller. On the early NES, it was a side-scroller. One of the hardest games I ever played, video games I ever played. But we haven't gotten an updated Metroid game in a really long time. It wasn't one from the Wii U. There's not going to be one for the Wii U. It'll be on Nintendo's next system. So, this Samus figure, Samus statue is available for pre-order. Now, I will post links in the description of the video so you can go check out that statue from Metroid. First for figures. So now we have another video game statue. Wong, this one looks really cool. This is another statue from Gaming Heads, who makes a lot of video game statues. This is the Doom Knee Deep in the Dead statue, right? So, you know, we got a new Doom game.
Just came out?
Yeah, today or yesterday? Maybe today?
I think it was like Wednesday, wasn't it?
Because it came out on Uncharted, right? Like 2 days after Uncharted, so I know it's out now. It just recently came out. So this is back to the art from the first game, right? So back in the day, I used to play Doom on my PC.
All day?
Right, all day. Beat it. This looks like a really cool nostalgic statue from Gaming Heads.
Brings you back to old school.
Yeah. Gaming Heads on Facebook says this is selling out fast.
Yeah.
Which is interesting. Gaming Heads statues don't tend to sell out too fast, but you know, Doom just came out. People are pumped for Doom.
Yeah, super hyped.
Yeah, super hyped. The statue, $375. Let's see. It doesn't really say
how big it is.
Uh, 12.5 inches, it just says the dimensions. That could be width, that could be height. So $375 is for the regular edition. $399 for the exclusive edition, which is actually already sold out.
Wow.
Yeah, I know. I just found out about this statue. It's already sold out. So this would be a really cool video game statue.
Yeah.
I don't think I would have added it had I come across it, but yeah, that looks pretty awesome.
Yeah.
You know, I really do want to play the new Doom video game, but
you still got a lot.
Do I have time for it right now? No. Am I going to play it? Yeah, I want to play it, but you know, I'm still beating Uncharted 3. Then I have Uncharted 4. Then I want to play Medieval, not Medieval, but the Warhammer strategy on the PC game that's coming out next week that I really want to play. Yeah. That's going to take up a lot of time. I've been spending too much time sitting in this room, building shelves, putting lights up, rearranging statues, staring at my freaking spreadsheet. Too much time on statues to play video games lately.
You're pretty much done, though.
Yeah, it's getting to a point to where I can hopefully play more games. So that's the Doom Knee Deep in the Dead statue from Gaming Heads. If you want to pre-order that, I'll post the link in the description. Hopefully, it's not sold out by Sunday.
Yeah.
But, you know, I posted this on Facebook a few days before this video comes out. So follow me on Facebook and give my page a like to stay as up-to-date as possible. So go ahead and check out that statue from Gaming Heads. So now we have some stuff from Imaginarium Art. Green Goblin, right?
Yes. We've been seeing a bunch of work from about this one.
They're retooling it, redoing it. They're completely different.
Yeah, that's what I was wondering too. I don't know if they, you know, looked at my comment or something, but it's completely different.
Oh, I'm sure they looked at your comment.
Yeah.
So, you know, they're redoing the Green Goblin. They're changing up the pose, right? Because they had him first on his sled.
I remember looking down or something like that.
Yeah, so, you know, Sideshow is also doing one on a sled. There's a custom one on a sled. So Imaginarium Art probably saw all that and said, you know what? We're going to do something different.
Mm-hmm.
So I don't have the full image here, but he's going to be, like, pointing.
Yes.
And his sled is going to be, like, coming over the top. And separate from him. So this is a different take on the Green Goblin. Again, really cool.
Yeah, very classic look. Suit, you know, it's fine.
Yeah, lots of good details, right? Yeah, so it should be cool. I can't wait to see this printed printed up again. And then we have a little preview, some digital work of Imaginarium Art, the Transformers line. This is the Hot Rod or Rodimus Prime. You know about this character?
No, Rodimus Prime? Never heard of
him. Hot Rod, yeah. So Transformers the movie back in the 80s was huge when I was a kid. I loved that movie.
Mm-hmm.
Optimus Prime dies.
Okay.
And then Hot Rod picks up the mantle of leadership for the Transformers and becomes the new leader of the Transformers. And comes Rodimus Prime.
That's cool.
So this is the character from that. I always loved this character when I was a kid, so... So this is just the early digital progress. So
yeah,
you can see it's very stagnant now, but...
It looks really cool, to be honest. The huge thing right now is what the pictures that we just had are given. I really hope his eyes grow. That'd be so cool.
Yeah, it would be cool.
Right.
You know, I want at least one Transformer statue in my collection. I can't start a line of Transformers.
Yeah, they're usually expensive and huge, too.
Yeah, but this is Imaginarium Art, so... yeah, we'll see... We'll see more from them on their Transformers. So next up is another Kylo Ren statue. This is from Iron Studios.
Okay.
So they're 1/10 scale mixed media. It looks like mixed media line. So this is Kylo Ren. So getting a lot of Star Wars statues lately.
Yep.
And then you can see him facing off against Rey.
Good thing is that, from what I'm aware of, I think the lightsabers do go this time. Could be wrong.
I do not know. It looks like in this initial picture, but I don't know if
it could be Photoshop kind of thing. But
yeah, could be. Looks like they might. Yeah, it looked really cool, but 1/10 scale is really small.
Yeah.
So may not. I wouldn't bet on them like that, but maybe they do. We'll keep you up to date on whether they do or not, and we'll keep showing more of the Star Wars statues from Iron Studios. You know, you can't buy those directly in the United States. These aren't for sale on Sideshow, so you have to get them through buy-sell trade groups or on eBay. Now, another smaller scale statue.
This is
1/10 from Kotobukiya, starting a Batman the Animated Series line. Right?
Also, so, I really love the series too.
Yeah, everybody loves the series, you know. It's a little hard to watch now, but...
No, I'm still watching now.
But not as much as, like, when I go back and watch Thundercats or He-Man or something. It's really hard to watch. But it's just hard to watch because of, I think, the quality. to try to go back and watch that a smaller scale.
Like 480p.
Yeah, I mean, they're still good episodes, but, you know, the quality of it has degraded a little bit over time in comparison. So this, you know, is the ArtFX Plus statue. 1/10 scale, based on the characters from DC Comics and a new direction with the Batman animated series version. So $50 for this statue.
It's really good.
Yeah, not bad.
Yeah.
You know, these Kotobukiya statues are really good. You know, they don't have to be all that detailed because this is an animated character. Exactly. You know, I would like an animated Batman in my collection. I don't know, 1/10 scale might be a little small. You know, I have a couple action figures. They don't have displayed, but you know, I do need an animated Batman in my collection too. So $50. Yes, yeah, maybe I'll pick them up. Yeah, because I'm kind of having trouble. Cause I have some of the action figures from DC Collectibles. Mm-hmm. Kind of having trouble figuring out how to display them. Yeah. So if I got this, it might be a little bit easier, right? Mm-hmm. That's the DC Comics Batman Animated ArtFX Plus statue from Kotobukiya, and it's available to pre-order now. Prime One Studios up next, Kwong.
Yep.
And this first image, what is that?
It says Anime World.
Yeah, Prime One Studio Anime World. Prime One is creating a separate division for anime-related statues.
Okay, nice.
So, are you a big anime fan?
I used to be when I was a kid. I barely like watching one now, which is like Death Note, because people keep telling me to watch it for some reason.
So, I'm not a big anime fan. I'm not an anime fan at all, you know. Anime, maybe I watched a couple Street Fighter
animes. Yeah, Street Fighter was good.
But, you know, I don't think Prime One's going to be doing that license. You know, I'm not very familiar with any of these sort of anime. They've been posting some more pictures of different anime ideas that they have, and people have been sharing a lot of anime ideas with Prime One of anime statues that they want made. I have no idea. You know, they announced a Guyver license.
Yeah. The Guyver one looked actually really good.
I have no idea what that is.
I think it's kind of like Transformer kind of thing. Could be wrong.
So, you know, I'm someone who knows a little about a lot of things, but anime is something that I know nothing about. So I'm probably not going to cover a lot of those anime statues on this show.
If anything, I'll do it for you.
Okay.
Because I know most of the animes. I don't watch them, but
I just don't have a lot of interest in it. If you do have a lot of interest in anime and want to see what Prime One Studio is up to, check out the Prime One Studio Collectors group on Facebook. You can get a lot more info on that. Also, I think the guys at Rad Titan, Alex is a big anime fan. Cool. He knows a lot more about that. So check out their collector's chats. I'm sure they'll share some more info on the anime that I'm completely clueless about. And that's from Prime One Studio. And then now we have something you've been asking about.
Batmobile.
Yeah, that's right. The Prime One Studio Batmobile.
I think it's on Sideshow right now. Currently already able to pre-order?
Yeah,
last time I checked.
It is up for pre-order now. There are only 500 of these being made. An edition size of 500. It is a little bit pricey.
Yeah. Right?
It's a $1,599, right? But you can do it on a payment plan, $180 a month.
Mm-hmm.
It's awesome. I would really like to own this. Height is 13.74 inches. Base is 26 inches by 25 inches wide. It's gonna be a big boy.
Yeah.
Coming out, guess when it's coming out? Guess.
First quarter
of next year, which I have no room in my budget for that.
Well, the huge thing is that we've always been hearing a bunch of statues for, you know, the first quarter of the year, but most of them are usually delayed, a lot of them.
I hope some get delayed, but yeah, I would love to have this. It's not something, I just think it would take up a lot of real estate.
Yeah.
Yeah, something, yeah, looks awesome. The light up features look great. It's definitely going to be big. I think it would look great on top of my PAX display with the 1/3 Batman statues
on
the bottom. I think that would look sweet. That's going to take up some real estate for some other things.
Yeah.
And I don't know if I can afford that real estate right now. But
better think fast. It's limited edition then.
Yeah, only 500. You know, the Hot Toys 1989 Batmobile was only 500 bucks.
Yeah.
This one,
but it was this. This one's bigger though than Hot Toys.
I don't think so.
No.
No.
Oh.
No, because the Hot Toys one was 1/6 scale. You can put the Batman Hot Toy inside.
Okay, that's sad.
So you know, this one probably gonna be, you know, 2 feet similar, similar in size. So it's 3 times the price though. But you know, it's gonna be.
I'm sure I'll shoot missiles and everything out everywhere.
It's gonna be a different animal. Looks like a different animal completely. But yeah, I don't have the room in my budget. Yeah, everything's coming out during that period, so.
I'm sure half of the stuff that you're pre-ordering is gonna be delayed. I guarantee it.
You guarantee it?
Guarantee it.
Okay. So, but this Batmobile Polystone Diorama by Prime One Studio is available to order on the Sideshow website now. I will post a link in the description of the video if you want to go get some business done with Sideshow. Now, Kwong, a company that's been quiet lately since that big Ryu pre-order. You know, we saw a little bit of Oni from them last week. This week in their newsletter, they posted a little picture of their Conan the Barbarian 1/3 scale statue, which is looking really cool. Get some more info on that pre-order in the next couple of weeks. On their Instagram page, they posted a little picture of a new bust that they're working on. No idea what this bust is, but they're working on another bust, so it'll be interesting to see what bust they're going to be working on. Their busts look pretty kick-ass.
Yeah, I've seen the Akuma ones. Pretty crazy.
Really, really cool. And then also, the big boot.
It looks like a Street Fighter character boot.
So this is the boot of the next 1/3 scale Street Fighter statue from Pop Culture Shock.
Nash?
Chun-Li.
Really?
Chun-Li will be the next 1/3 scale statue.
Okay.
I'm not getting any more 1/3 scale Street Fighter statues, right? I'm already dying for space. You know, there are some characters that might entice me if they did them in 1/3 scale.
Like
Zangief?
That'd be he's cool. Pretty popular.
That'd be too big.
Yeah.
I want a 1/4 scale Zangief. Because our past Zangief is like really, really expensive.
Yeah.
Really sought after, really expensive. So hopefully they'll do a new one. I'm sure they will. And I heard they're doing another 1/4 scale Bison.
Nice.
So that'll be
Bison's awesome.
Yeah, that'll be cool as well. So more interested in their 1/4 scale statues now. I have 3 of their 1/3 on order. 2 Street Fighter, but 1 Mortal Kombat.
Don't you have Ken too?
1/3.
Oh, okay.
We have a 1/4 scale Ken, so. Yeah, so no more 1/3 for me, but I'm sure this will be another bloodbath. Chun-Li being you know, another popular Street Fighter character. So we're looking forward to seeing more good stuff from Pop Culture Shock. It looks like they are getting back to work. Well, I'm sure they've been working this whole time.
Yeah.
They're starting to show a couple of things again. So we'll keep you up to date on Pop Culture Shock. Sideshow Collectibles is up next.
Yep.
And they have a big, big pre-order that came up. And I do literally mean that in size. So Sideshow has the Alien King Maquette, which we talked about
a couple of weeks ago.
Now, when first seeing this, I was initially thinking, I'm going to pre-order this guy. Mm-hmm. But after seeing the price, I'm probably not going to pre-order this guy. Not saying that it's not worth it, but... you know, I really would like an alien statue in my collection. Mm-hmm.
think this is quarter scale?
Some of these maquettes and stuff aren't necessarily to scale.
Okay.
If you think about the Alien King, mm-hmm. how big?
Yeah.
So if they were to do a quarter scale, how big would it be, right? So this isn't to scale, but it is 20 inches tall and 21 inches long. So honestly, that's not too big. 20 inches tall is not very big statue,
mm-hmm.
right? 21 inches long is a little bit big. But in terms of height, it's not too big.
Yeah, it's not bad.
Yeah, it's actually pretty reasonable. So 21 inches tall, but the price is $999.99, right? So that's a little pricey for a statue of that size, but it does have insane detail on it.
Yeah, and it's a one of a kind too, because it's something that Sideshow made up.
Right.
Yeah.
So this is comes from the mind of Sideshow, a partnership with Legacy FX, and they are the artists and nightmare makers behind the creatures and queen from Aliens. So the same people who worked on the Aliens helped them create this.
Nice.
So this is for an Alien fan,
mm-hmm.
Really, really cool. I'd like to have one Alien statue in my collection. But honestly, I don't think the time is right yet.
Mm-hmm.
It's because I'm waiting on some more reveals.
Yeah.
Some more reveals. So the Alien King Maquette by Sideshow Collectibles, available to pre-order on the Sideshow website now, $999.99, or their convenient payment plans for $112.50 a month. I don't currently do payment plans, but I might start doing payment plans.
Yeah.
Makes it a little bit easier to budget, a little bit more reasonable, than $1,000 chunk at one time.
Yeah.
So that's really cool that Sideshow does that. Again, link in the description of the video if you want to go to Sideshow and get some business done for that Alien King Maquette. Now, Sideshow also showed off a little sneak preview of their new Teenage Mutant Ninja Turtles statues.
Yeah.
Right?
This one we're super excited for.
Yeah, I am excited for it. These are comic book based versions, mm-hmm. but they are not based specific on a specific comic book. They're not based off the cartoon. They're a separate, they're a new design coming from Sideshow Collectibles.
Nice.
The same guy who does the dragons from Game of Thrones also is doing the designs for these turtles. So these are going to be completely new and unique designs, right? They're supposed to be smaller than quarter scale, more closely to 1/5 scale for the statues. And they have a set of four turtles. Not much more info than that. I am really looking forward to seeing more.
Yeah, me too.
I'm gonna, initially when I saw this, I was like, oh, that's awesome. I've been waiting for more comic book versions.
Yeah.
I used to own their Comiquettes and I sold them off, and they were really cool statues, but they are really expensive. So hopefully, these turtles will be more reasonably priced. Hopefully the original Comiquettes were $200 when they first came out. And they sell anywhere from $7 to $1,000 each. So hopefully this will be like more in the $400 price range.
Mm-hmm.
Initially when I saw this, I said, wow, these are gonna be instant buy for me. But because it's a different design and it's a design we haven't seen before, I'm gonna hold off to see more first.
More pictures, yeah.
Yeah, I'm gonna hold off to see more first. I do really like the Ninja Turtles. I have a bunch of Ninja Turtles stuff in books and comics and stuff in my collection. Hoping to one day get that Teenage Mutant Ninja Turtles first issue in my collection at some point. It's not too pricey, but I'm going to need a big bonus or a big tax return or something to pick that up, or get lucky in a auction or something.
Yeah.
Might be good. Looking forward to seeing more of the Teenage Mutant Ninja Turtles from Sideshow. Also, pre-order coming next week, which means we'll see some more pictures of the first order Stormtrooper.
Yeah, this one I was saying last week, I was super excited. I don't know if I want to get it, but it looks really good.
It looks really cool. Yeah. The pre-order will be out on May 19th. Mm-hmm. It'll be interesting to see how well this statue does.
Yeah. Do we know how much it is yet? I'm thinking it's going to be like the 500 range.
No, it'll probably be in the 500 range. Yeah. That's about what Sideshow is running these days. I'm guessing under 500. Mm-hmm. The Stormtroopers. Yeah, I don't know what that Sand Trooper, I think it was a little under 500, so
yeah.
Hopefully this will be the same. Mm-hmm. They don't have like crazy bases or anything on their Star Wars statues. Yeah. More simple, so the price should be a little bit more simple too, but I'll post up on Thursday. Thanks for that pre-order on the website and the Facebook page.
XM
Studios, Quam.
Yep.
First up, digital sculpting of Black Cat.
Yeah.
Looking forward to seeing more of this.
Yeah, because I remember last time we saw her, what's going to be right under her is a huge cat as well.
Mm-hmm.
That's if I remember correctly. Looks really good. Curious how it's going to be. Looking forward to the paint, sure.
Yeah, and I'm really looking forward to it. I don't know if something that I'll pick up, but I'm looking forward. I think it'll be a cool statue. We're also seeing another Spider-Man character in Carnage. The artwork for Carnage.
It's a little... I'm not really sure how I feel about this one. Like, it looks nice, but the symbiote popping out from his back, I don't know, I have... Like, even though that does happen in the comics and the movies and, like, the animated series and all stuff, it just doesn't look right to me. But maybe it probably because it hasn't been painted yet.
Well, he's supposed to be busy, right?
Yeah.
It'll probably be a better contrast when he's red and black.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. Probably be better contrast. It's going to be a tough paint job.
Yeah.
To get done. Yeah. So, looking forward to seeing more of that Carnage. And you can see he has a second head.
It's actually pretty not that bad. I'm really glad that they're actually putting that in.
Yeah. So, yeah, it looks really cool. Be interesting to see when it's painted up. Right.
Yeah,
we'll see that. And then we have Kingpin, printed Kingpin. Mm-hmm. So this is the printed Kingpin, right?
This one looks really... Also, I think it looks phenomenal. I don't know, last time when we saw him, was there the table right there? Did we have that table on there as well?
Yeah.
That's a really nice touch.
Yeah.
Actually, that's really interesting because I can't think of another statue that has kind of like an additional part that's kind of like that, you know?
Mm-hmm.
So that's kind of unique.
Yeah, no real base on him.
Yeah.
Right, he's sitting there with mm-hmm. the chest table, so you can move the chest table to the side.
Yeah.
And explain without it, if you'd like, is what it looks like. And the little chest pieces on the board are really cool.
Yeah, it's a good touch.
I really like this Kingpin statue, you know, something I would think about getting.
Yeah.
You know, if XM was more accessible, a little bit easier to get and a little bit more reasonably priced, right? Mm-hmm. As far as U.S. collecting goes, you'd probably get them for under $1,000.
Well, that's not bad.
Probably.
Yeah.
I'm guessing, so.
$1,000 is actually pretty reasonable.
Yeah.
Especially for an XM piece, too.
Yeah. I'm still thinking about that question, is XM Studios worth it? I'm still thinking about it, so I'm going to do my reviews, and I'll answer that question after my reviews. So, that's XM Studios. Now, that's it for this week's previews and pre-orders. So, speaking of XM Studios, Kwong, do you know what time it is?
Question of the week.
So finally you can read the screen and tell us that it's time for the question of the week. So this week's question of the week comes to us from the Prime Collector. He says, awesome talk, brother, is very entertaining. Thank you, Prime Collector. A questions, bro, Sideshow and Prime 1 statues are made with polystone, and XM Studio statues are made out of cold cast porcelain. What's your opinion on the type of material that they used and why? Thanks. So, Kwong, what do you think?
Well, the huge thing is that Spider-Man that you gave me is Polystone. I don't have really a huge problem with it. For me, it's hard to say the difference from the XM Studio statue because I personally don't have one. So I feel like this question is more towards you than me. But for me, Polystone, I feel, has been a go-to for a bunch of statues in the past and now. So I don't see a problem with it. But then again, now moving the question over to you, I do like the blackboard a lot. And I didn't really feel the material yet, mm-hmm. but the Spider-Man one that I have from J. Scott Campbell seemed fine. I could have, maybe details could have been a lot better, but still, I think it's a good statue.
So if the details could have been better, does that, you think that has something to do with Polystone?
Probably, because I'm thinking porcelain is more like, kind of like ceramic, right? You know?
I think you're just throwing information out of your ass.
It's
because you.
I don't know.
Because it doesn't. It doesn't really matter. They both hold detail kind of the same way. So this is a I don't know a lot about the technical reasons why one company chooses one or the other. Mm-hmm. So when doing some research, you know, it says. What is polystone? Polystone is a compound made up largely of polyurethane resin mixed with powdered stone additives that give it added weight and a stone-like feel and durability. So what is a cold cast porcelain? It's an inexpensive, non-toxic, easy to work with material. Despite its name, it is not porcelain. Its main components are cornstarch and white glue, but can also include low quantities of oils and glycerol, which promote a porcelain-like smooth texture. So they are both cheap ways of making statues. Mm-hmm. They both hold, from what I can tell between the two, the same amounts of detail. Mm-hmm. You know, and feeling the statues, you know, it's also difficult to tell because, you know, if I have Black Bolt and I have the new Spider-Man premium format, you touch them, they do feel a little bit different. You knock on them, they do feel a little bit different. But if I take two polystone statues and I touch them and I knock on them, they feel a little bit different. They each have different weights. They do have each have different thicknesses. But from feeling both of those two statues, you know, because Spider-Man has rods in them. The other statues might have rods in them too to hold them up. So that's a heavier part. Yeah, they're both cheap ways to make statues.
Something that I was curious about is, I'm thinking maybe cold porcelain, it looks a little bit more shinier than the polystone. Am I right, or you don't really know?
Well, that paint, you know, they use different paints too, so you can't really judge from that.
Okay.
So feeling the statues, they feel both very similar. From what I can tell, comparing the Spider-Man premium format to Black Bolt and Daredevil, they both have good weight. If I were to say that Black Bolt and Daredevil feel a little bit thinner, you know, just giving them a slight little knock on them, they do feel a little bit thinner. But in terms of quality-wise, I don't think there's any big difference.
Okay.
So this argument comes up more when talking about polystone versus PVC.
Mm-hmm.
Lots of people who collect statues don't like PVC.
What's PVC?
PVC is plastic.
Oh, okay.
Right? But they're both, you know, they're both kind of synthetic materials, right?
Mm-hmm.
And I think PVC, I've heard it said that PVC is actually more expensive to make than polystone.
Okay.
And PVC holds details really well. Like when you see, you know, face sculpts, tiny little details. You know, I think there's a bigger difference between, you know, polystone and cold cast porcelain than there is in PVC, you know. As far as, you know, comparing those two together, I don't see a big difference. But if you were to compare those two to PVC, you know, there might be a lot more detail that you can get in a PVC statue.
Okay.
So,
nice.
So, you know, that's just my opinion based on my in-hand thoughts. I don't know the science behind why Sideshow does Polystone, why XM Studios does Cold Cast. So, could be that the factory XM Studios found does Cold Cast better. Could be maybe they found it to be cheaper, easier to work with.
Yep.
You know, that's a lot of technical manufacturing reasons, I'm sure, behind that I just am not don't know a lot about that part of the process, right? So I'm not equipped to answer those questions in more detail, but from what I saw in person, they're both very similar. So thanks, Prime Collector, for sending in your question. Kwong, you have something to share in this week's collection update.
Yep. So for me, like we were talking about earlier in the episode, went to IKEA, got you those lights, and then I got a detail for myself. So here's a picture of my setup. I updated a little bit compared to the last time I gave it to you. Had, you know, Spider-Man's on top, popcorn of Civil War right there.
You like Spider-Man a lot.
Well, yeah. And then I put in a Black Cat in there. That's pretty new. And then Kingdom Hearts, the 2.5 collection. It's one of my favorite games.
Kingdom Hearts, yep. Spider-Man. That's not your Black Cat, though, right?
No.
Okay.
Yeah. And then Catherine Collector's Edition is my first Collector's Edition game I ever got. The game was pretty fun, too. Recommend it. That's a lot of...
I don't play video games for titties, Kwong.
I do!
That's what Pornhub is for. Have you ever heard of... free internet porn? You don't need to go to video games.
But yeah, that's a...
sneaking boobies.
That's pretty much it. I was thinking about getting another detox because of the white one. I have to exchange it. I don't have room for it, though.
Mm-hmm.
That's the huge problem right now, because I do need to make some space, especially... I think it's in August that Symbiote's supposed to be coming out from Sideshow. Mm-hmm. So, not 100% sure what I'm going to do yet, but I'm going to see probably what you're going to be doing with... adjustables for the detail, and then I'll probably take down the Catherine at the very bottom and put the J. Scott stamp on the bottom, and then put a single Spider-Man.
Okay.
And that's pretty much mine.
And you're gonna take one of my pedestals, maybe?
Oh yeah. I'm gonna put it right there, just kind of next.
Sure. See how that goes, but
yeah.
So far it looks cool.
Yeah, I like it a lot, actually.
Yeah.
And then good. I have that that amazing Spider-Man one. Mm-hmm. I wanted that redone. The one that you gave me,
yep.
Put it right back there. Because it just felt a little empty, because, you know, it was way too, the base for the Spider-Man was just way too big, so I couldn't put it on one thing, so I took it down, and I was just like, it looks a little empty right here. I'm like, bam, I'll put a comic book. Yeah.
So great. That's what the wire clips will help you do, is to get rid of that space. So did you double up that shelf that Spider-Man is on?
What do you mean double up?
Double up. Did you put two shelves on there?
No, was I supposed to?
I would recommend putting two shelves on there. Because you have one extra, right?
Yeah, I do.
Yeah, so double up that one where the Spider-Man is on. Hold more weight. Not that you have a lot of weight on there, but just to make sure nothing falls down. So, looking like a cool little small collection there.
Since my room is like super small too, so I have a room like this.
Well,
you just got me addicted now. Now that I'm on the show, I just want to buy everything.
Yeah, that's a problem.
Yeah.
That's a problem. That's a problem for me too, you know. I've been, so let's share a couple of videos that I shot this week.
Sure.
Of me installing the lights in my room. So the first video shows what my room is like after I pulled all these cabinets from the wall. It was kind of like a little maze in here. So pro tip is put in lights before you put the cabinets in. I thought I was going to be okay with the cabinets without lights for a while, but when I put them in, because of the depth, no light was getting in there. So it made it really dark. So first video is me with the cabinets out, and then I have some updates of the videos of me with the lights in and everything cleaned up. You can see I've started to put statues in the background, so let's take a look at those two videos.
Hello, collectors. Joe Protzik here with a quick update on my collection room. As you can see here, recently picked up some Diodor lights from IKEA. These are LED lights to help with the display. After receiving the packs and setting it up, I realized that the depth caused a lot of darkness in the display, so I definitely needed some lights. So I got four packages of the Diodor disc lights, multicolor LED lights, and one package of the strip lights to provide an effect on top. So let's take a little bit at my room. As you can see, I have lots of stuff outside of the room while I work on it. So here is what the room looks like right now. Quite a bit different. If you watched the last episode of Statue Talk, you got to see I was making some progress in the background. But as I wanted to do the lights right, I needed access to the back. So here's a little bit about what my statue room looks like now. Got all the stuff put aside on the tables. And I have a little bit of a maze to go through to reach the backs of my shelves. So I've drilled some holes to where the lights are gonna go. It literally is like a little maze back here. Needed access to get behind all of the shelves. So now over here, I went ahead and grabbed an extension cord. I got one with a flat edge to it so it can actually sit behind the bookshelf. Has a flat head on it, so it's about an inch away from the wall, which the cabinets were beforehand. Otherwise, all of my outlets are completely covered up by the cabinets. So I needed to find a solution to plug these lights in. So I'm literally sliding through my cabinets. So those are the holes in the cabinet themselves. Not too big, the wires are pretty small. So I'm going to be installing those lights now. And then once I do, I will update you with another video showing off what it looks like with those lights installed. Okay, here is what the room looks like with the lights installed. You can see I have them on the pulsing mode right now. Actually, I have a couple different modes. They can be a single color. They can pulse like this. Or they can actually flash like that. So right now I do have them installed with the 3M tape on the bottom. And installed with the sticky. I've actually come into the room and had a couple have fallen off the shelves already. So that's after a day. Two of the lights have already been falling down. So I'm thinking about, you can actually screw them in as well. So I'm thinking about doing that because I don't want them to fall down on top of a statue. The other thing I'm gonna do is I was going to install some brackets to go along the top of the shelf. Now these are for the shelves themselves, not wouldn't be for the top of the cabinet. But the brackets are going to be used to keep the shelves themselves from bowing in. They have a tendency to sag, and so I'm hoping that these brackets will help prevent the sagging. I think they won't look too obtrusive in the display, so that's going to be my next step before installing any of the statues. One thing that I did want to show you was a little bit of the mess that is on top of the cabinets themselves. I got the, had to get a low profile surge protector up there for the lights so they would be able to fit, the plug would be able to fit behind the outlet that's behind the cabinets. So it is a little bit of a mess, but you know, standing down here, you can't really see it. Even if you go all the way back to the entrance to the door, and maybe you can barely see it up there. So it is going to be easy to cover up. Just put behind a statue that's going to go up there. Now I also am planning on putting some lights on top. I'll be putting some, probably a puck light over on the left and a puck light over on the right. And then some strip lights for the two center displays to light up any statues that are going to be on top. So once I finish with that work, I will update you again on my progress. Oh, as you can see, the lights are finished. They're on. I added strip lights to the top. Secured them using the 3M stickies that were included. I also secured the controllers with some 3M stickies as well. That would be my only complaint is, well, one complaint is, so you can kind of see those controllers at the top, but you know, for me being 5'11", I can just reach them right where they are, so I don't have to go getting a step stool or anything to get on top. These are the 75-inch or 79-inch IKEA PAX units, so they are pretty tall, but I wanted to be able to reach those lights. There is a little bit of a mess up here with the wires. Again, standing, you know, looking at the display from what this is about 5 feet away, can't really even see the wires. All right, and as we get further away, you know, you still can't really see them. So maybe right here, which is the very entry to my room, you can see them a little bit. You know, they're going to be statues and whatnot in front of it, so those will be covered up and easy to hide. I don't want to put a blanket or anything, create a fire hazard. You know, it's just something I'll have to live with. I'm a little worried about those lights falling off the top. I don't know if they're secure enough to stay there permanently. They do have screws, but the screws were really, really small, and I don't have a drill bit that small. So that is an option. You know, if the lights do fall down and they hit something, they're not, you know, terribly heavy, so I think I'll be okay. We'll see how it goes over the next couple of days. Now here is Pinhead under the light. I just put him here for now. I think this might be his permanent home, but I put him here for now just as kind of a demonstration of the lights. You know, one thing I asked myself after doing all this work, pulling out the shelves, unscrewing everything, drilling holes in the back, dealing with all the wires, the plugs, etc. I had to ask myself, well, is it really worth it? And yeah, I think it was. You know, the light packs cost about $30 each. I got six of them. So, you know, $180. Sorry, I actually got five of them. So, yeah, about $150. The effect is subtle. You know, I think a lot of the light is absorbed by the black background of it, so it doesn't put too much on the sides. And though I think it looks really good, I think it's going to come off really good in photos and as a backdrop for the YouTube videos. And then I just wanted to show you the... I don't even know if you can see it here.
brackets I installed. Probably not enough light for you to see them, but I installed those to keep the shelves from bowing. We'll be able to see how that works over time. Now I'll just show you a little bit. The effect of the lights gets kind of drowned out by that overhead light a little bit. So I'm gonna turn them off just to show you what the lights look like. Sort of the effect. Not that I'm gonna sit here and look at my statues in the dark. If I keep that overhead light and maybe add some lamps or, you know, have brighter lights for the videos, that might work a little bit better. It does have, you can see the effect the lights are having on the wall and the ceiling. And then when you look at the shelves, it doesn't quite have that effect, right? Because the black brown of the shelves is absorbing the lights, whereas the white on the ceilings and the wall is reflecting the light, making it look a lot better. So that's something that you're going to want to think about when choosing what color of shelves that you want, you know, and if you're going to install lights, especially colored lights, you know, how that light is going to reflect, or you know, how it's not going to reflect. So overall, I'm really happy with the setup. Next step would be doors. I think that's going to be a long ways away. Get everything behind glass, or rather acrylic glass. So now this is where the fun part starts, is setting up the statues and figuring out where everything is going to go. I'll be updating you as that progresses.
And now that we've taken a look at those two videos, as you can see, I got the lights on in the background. I've started to put some statues up where they belong. And yeah, so far I'm really digging the lights. As long as the overhead light isn't on, they stand out really well.
Yep.
When the overhead light is on though, it like drowns everything out. Drowns those lights out, because they're not too bright, but they have like a very subtle and slight effect on the statues. But it's really like, you can't see the top here. Putting lights on top of the packs really kind of reflects off the white of it.
Nice.
But you'll see, so you've seen in my my video. So I will do a collection tour and update once I finished putting things in their homes. Yeah. I started to put up more artwork, as you can see around. I am gonna box up a couple of statues, probably for sale.
Okay.
As I'm doing this and I'm finally putting statues where they belong, you know, and then I have a spreadsheet. So I'll throw up an image of the spreadsheet where I have my plan, what statues are gonna come in and where I want them to go. As I'm doing that and I'm assessing my collection, I realize I'm gonna be running out of room. You can see I have room in the back now. I have a lot of empty shelves, but there's a lot of stuff coming that's gonna take up room. And then within the next year and a half or so, I'm gonna be struggling for space.
Yeah.
So a couple statues on the chopping block, they're at least gonna get boxed up for now. It's the T-800 Terminator. He's got a home right now, but he's gonna get bumped for something else, I'm sure. And then the Anakin Skywalker premium format doesn't have a spot in my collection anymore. So I might sell that one. And then another statue I'm debating on is Darth Malgus premium
format. I really like that one.
I really like it too, and he's with the video game statues right now. Mm-hmm. You know, I think he'll stay there for a little bit because he does fit in there. But where he's gonna go, he might get bumped for something else.
Yeah.
Couple of statues I'm thinking about taking off my pre-order list. You know, one thing that a lot of collectors have been doing is canceling Prime 1 Arkham Knight statues.
Really?
Yeah, lots of people have been canceling Batman and canceling Arkham Knight, and not picking up more of those 1/3 scale statues. People are starting to realize the amount of space that they're going to take up,
mm-hmm.
not only in the collection, but also in the budget.
Yeah.
You know, more so, it's about space in the collection now.
Yeah.
You know, they're not too They don't have too wide of a basis, but they are very tall. Mm-hmm. And how many 1/3 scale statues can you really have? You know, I've got a spot picked out right behind me here where some of those Arkham Knight statues are going to go. You know, I'm not going to be canceling those main Arkham Knight statues. You know, I have Batman, Robin, Arkham Knight, Deathstroke. Those are definitely going to stay. Mm-hmm. I am thinking about chopping the Batman Noel still. Just because looking at my collection plan, I don't know where he's going to go.
Yeah,
makes sense. And he is putting me a bit over my budget that month. Just because as things get pushed, keep getting pushed back, and then things keep showing up in 1 month. So I'm a little bit over budget there. And honestly, I don't know where he's going to fit in the collection. You know, I said they can't have too many Batman statues. No. But I think you can have too many 1/3 scale Batman statues, right? Where am I going to put these things? So, you know, there are some more 1/3 scale Batman statues coming from Prime 1. You know, they're going to do the origins of Batman. Mm-hmm. They're going to do some of the villains. You know, I want to pick up a couple villains. You know they're going to do a Joker.
Yeah.
I'd love to pick up a Scarecrow, too. Then they're going to do a Jim Lee Batman.
Are that the company doing Wasteland 2 or no?
That's XM Studios. So then they're going to do... they're doing the Dark Knight Batman, which I won't get, but they're doing, you know, an Arkham Knight. Batman has, you haven't played Arkham Knight.
No.
So in Arkham Knight, Batman starts in one costume, and then he, early on in the game, he switches to this costume that is on the statue.
Oh, okay.
But they're going to do that first costume as well. They're going to do the 1989 Batman costume. All these statues in 1/3 scale, you know. You got to draw the line somewhere. And, you know, when I think about, you know, Sideshow's going to have a lot of cool pieces at San Diego Comic-Con. Mm-hmm. They're going to have a Magneto.
Yeah.
They're going to have Thanos won't be there, but you know they're working on a Thanos. They're going to have their Venom. And then Prime One's New 52 DC line is going to be one I'm going to want to pick up.
Yeah,
so they're going to have those statues. And you know that Darkseid is going to be Giants. So where the... You know, F am I going to put him?
Yeah.
You know, and then, you know, I definitely want to get at least one of their Witcher statues.
What?
You know, I got to get Geralt from Witcher video games. Have more Mass Effect statues coming. They're going to release more of those. I got spots picked out for those. And then, you know, Prime 1 is also teasing a Warhammer 40K line.
Ooh. Wow.
You know, they're teasing it, so we're a long time, a long ways away from there. So, you know, I have some space, but, you know, it's going to get busy and crowded in here really quick. Really quick. So, I don't have the biggest... I'm lucky that I have a room just for my collectibles, but it's not the biggest room. And then as the statue companies come out with more and more stuff, you know... I don't know what's going to happen. Either I'm going to slow my collecting down, which I'm thinking it is going to slow down. It's because I'm going to have to be more picky for real estate, right? So, you know, in the next year or so, we are thinking about moving. So when we do that, I'm going to have my eye on a big collector room.
Yeah, that'd be
it's
nice.
I'm going to have my eye on that because I'm going to sort of expand. And I can also expand other rooms of the house, too. Mm-hmm. Best out in the living room, just keep everything behind glass. You know, we have a dog, we're getting another dog tomorrow. Hairy dogs get hair everywhere, so they're not allowed in this room, but if I put stuff outside, that definitely all has to be behind glass.
Yeah.
And not out in the open or on top of stuff here. So thinking about canceling that Batman Noel statue. Okay. A couple months still, and then I was gonna cancel the Sideshow Lex Luthor.
The one that you saw as a pre- no. Is that the president one?
No, that's him in his armor. I'd like it, but that's just one I think I'm just going to get the axe until I see what Prime 1 is doing with their New 52 line. So I think I want to focus on that.
A lot to think about.
Yeah, I spend hours
literally looking at my spreadsheet trying to figure it out. And then I have, you know, the Golden Ares, and then I have the Death Dealer on horse, which is a massive statue. Mm-hmm. I have no idea where those things are going to go.
Yeah.
Honestly. And that Golden Ares, it's been 3 months now since I sent him to ARH to get repaired, and I have no idea when I'm going to see that guy. So, you know, I have no idea where I'm going to put him either. Right now, he's waiting out in my hallway. That's where he might go, to be honest with you. Him or Death Dealer might go there. Yeah. Just as sort of the entrance to my room. So that's it for my collection. I posted up the unboxing of Daredevil on Friday, so go ahead and check that out. This week, now that I'm done rearranging my room, you know, I'm gonna shoot those reviews.
Yep.
For Daredevil and Black Bolt. Black Bolt will be first, so I'll do my full reviews of those two statues. I have a new camera. You might notice the look of the show has changed a little bit, so I bought a new video camera. Yeah, so I'll be shooting those reviews in 4K. So we'll see how that turns out. I'm not sure about still playing with the settings and the lighting and everything. Hopefully those videos don't get too grainy in the 4K. So I don't even have a 4K TV to watch 4K videos on, but I do have a 4K camera. And so I'm gonna shoot those reviews in 4K for any of you who have upgraded TVs or monitors. Mm-hmm. You have a 4K monitor for your?
No, I'm 20.
I thought you were a PC Master Race.
Yeah, but there's not really not much many 4K games. Like I said, Tomb Raider,
yeah.
Grand Theft Auto, you know, once we start jumping over there, mm-hmm. then for sure, I will.
Yeah, so, you know, for those of you that can, you know, I'll have those 4K videos out for you, so. More to come on my collection. Like I said, when everything is put up, which should be in the next week or two, of all the art and stuff where I want it, I will update you with a tour of my collection room. So that's it for this week's collection update. So Kwong, this week's featured video is another statue from XM Studios.
Nice.
Statue that I was kind of a little bit down on.
Mm-hmm.
After seeing this video, I'm changing my mind a little bit. I still don't think it's a statue for me, but it looks better than what I thought it was.
Yeah.
So this is the Thor quarter scale comic version from XM Studios. Unboxing and first impression by Sammy G. So go ahead and check out this video by Sammy G. I think the store looks a lot better in Sammy's video than some of the pictures I've seen. Still a little bit on the plain side for me, but then Sammy G throws up some cool pictures at the end of the video that really kind of had me changing my mind.
Okay, nice.
Good detail shots of that statue. So check out the XM Studios store quarter scale premium collectible unboxing and first impression by Sammy G. Hope you enjoyed this week's episode of Statue Talk. Let Kwong and I know what you think of some of the topics that we covered in the comment section below. We may even share some of your comments or questions on next week's episode. Now, if you're a statue addict like me, or a beginning collector like Kwong, and you can't wait a whole week for the latest statue news and pre-orders, check out my website, statuereview.com, and give me a like on Facebook. Try to share all the news from around social media on those two pages, pre-orders, pictures, any news, etc. Don't forget to subscribe to my channel to stay up to date on all of my latest unboxings and statue reviews. XM Studios Black Bolt and Daredevil full reviews coming up in the next couple of weeks. Now remember, statue collecting is more than just a hobby. It's a lifestyle. This is Joe Prodzik and
Kwong Tran
for Statue Review. Thanks for watching.
Big fan.
Okay. How long are you going to keep that on for?
I'm going to do it one more time,
so. So next week I'm going to shoot the episode solo, right?
That's probably
for the best. So Kwong, what I want to know is, which movie did you think was better? Batman versus Superman or Captain America Civil War? It doesn't matter what you think. You take your Captain America, you take your Iron Man, you even take your Spider-Man, and you shove them straight up your candy ass. If you smell what Batman is cooking.